wait and eat. He's gonna eat a good handful of these huge pellets. These are giant pellets, 7 millimeter in diameter and thick. And he's gonna easily overeat, and when I'm gonna be throwing their pieces of fish, he's gonna get those too. So Atan must go. He will kill himself here. Here comes the fish. They're not used to feeding in bright lights, so they're not gonna like it too much. Fish is gonna come in about 4 or 5 portions.
Well, it's just not enough for him. He also has to partake of some fish.
The alpha male arowana is holding babies in his mouth from our latest clutch. So he's not feeding the biggest arowana. The male is the mouth brooder. So he's probably got 30, 40 babies in his mouth for at least 6 weeks. It's been about two and a half weeks already. Portion of the fish. Usually they feed better because the light is, the filming light is not something they're used to. It stresses them out. But it wasn't too bad. So that's our feeding for tonight of this tank. The boss of the tank, for now at least. I'm told that maybe the dovii will take its place. The dovii just grabbed a good piece of fish holding in his mouth. He's by the back wall, so you probably don't see him too well. This tank is 13 feet wide. Water to see him clearly. What happens at the back?
I'll show you the normal lighting to which they're used to. This is their normal lighting. To them, this is normal. You see how they all spread out right away? Before they were in this right-hand side corner and half. Now Gil is coming up because he or she always comes up to hand feed. Everybody just relaxed instantly. I hope you caught it. As soon as I turned off the filming lights, everybody relaxed. You can see the difference in the swimming pattern. So they're like, dude, what are you doing to us? Why do you have to stress us out? Yeah, well, for the sake of filming you guys. Well, that's it for our show.